Hey everyone, I'm obviously not Paige, but just so you know, I will be replacing her this week while she's in rehab, or as she puts it, visiting family abroad. I know we're all tired and checked out after this horrible year, bad news after bad news, the economy's in a coma, the country risk has skyrocketed again. You're exhausted by all this and you're not even sure what the country risk given is. Sounds like a board game from the 80s. It's not, it's much worse. Argentina's own Me Too moment continues to make waves, and Congress this week passed the Micaela law, which mandates that all public sector employees in the three branches of government, from now on, must take part in a gender equality training program where participants learn about gender issues and violence towards women. The bill was voted by every single senator and deputy in both houses of Congress, except for one single deputy. You know who I'm talking about, Alfredo Olmedo, aka the most devastating thing to happen to yellow raincoats since the opening scene of Stephen King's It. Olmedo, the self-proclaimed Argentine Bolsonaro, who could totally become president next year because why the hell not, said he couldn't vote in favor because he didn't agree with gender ideology, because he maintains that God created men and women. If you don't understand what that means, that's fine, neither do I. In other news, and starting this week, there's a new 100 peso bill out there. So remember this before you accuse your friendly neighborhood kiosquero of trying to rip you off. I mean, he might, but not with this. The new bill is mostly violet and features a taruca, some sort of deer goat that I had to Google before coming here because I had never heard of it in my entire life. As it turns out, the North Andean deer is an endangered species living in the north of Argentina, and it looks kind of like Bambi was possessed by Satan. Literally worth $2.60. I wanna die. And speaking of money, or the lack of it, the Universidad Católica Argentina has issued a new report on poverty, and to the surprise of no one, it says that the poverty rate in the country this year climbed to 33.6%, which is quite a difference from last year when the number was around 28.7% and seemed to be decreasing. Nope, according to this new study, an additional 2.2 million people in Argentina fell below the poverty line in 2018, partly because of macro financial instability, a horrible drought, a sharp depreciation of the peso, the acceleration of inflation, and a decrease in the purchasing power of wages and salaries. When I say horrible year, this is exactly what I mean. At this rate, the only way for you to survive next year will be by either selling a kidney or becoming an Instagram influencer, you know, like Mirko, who's like 2 days old and already has 2.5 million followers, and a Martin Fierro. Meanwhile, the bubble has been around for almost 6 years, and we can't even get our Twitter account verified. Suck on that. I don't want to break any of the lights. I don't think my salary covers them. Woo! That was pathetic. Now moving on to events that I won't be participating in, but still I'm contractually obligated to talk about, with a glass of espumante this time because it's Christmas. So no wine for me this week. If you're like me and love the thrill of buying Christmas presents at the last minute, head to the Galleria Patio del Liceo in Palermo on Avenida Santa Fe for their annual pre-Christmas market this weekend. They have gifts of all prices, all items are individually produced and are sold by independent vendors. The best part, if you get bored, there will also be a bar and live music so you can recover and maybe you can run into Paige Nichols there, drowning her sorrows in alcohol. And if you're looking to feel smart on Saturday, head over to El Rosedal at 6 p.m. for an incredible evening. For you, that is. I'm just reading the teleprompter. The Teatro Colón's in-house orchestra and choir will be performing a special open-air end-of-the-year concert completely free of charge. It will include interpretations of great classical music by Verdi, Strauss, and Beethoven. They will close with Ode to Joy, so make sure that you bring your phone and Instagram the hell out of it before you get drunk on Saturday night to the wonderful tunes of Barbie Rican and her modern masterpiece, Calocha. Don't know what that is? Google it. Please Google it. Don't Instagram it though. Happy holidays, everyone. See you next year. Cheers. Paige, good luck in rehab. We'll be waiting. I actually suck at using Instagram. It's like every time that I post something, I lose followers instead of gaining followers. Clearly something I'm doing wrong. I can't deal with the whole, with the selfies, you know, like the selfies at the elevator, selfies in the bathroom, half naked selfies at the gym, and don't even get me started on the half naked selfies after CrossFit. Nothing screams insecurity like selfies after CrossFit on Instagram. You know what I love? It's like when they do this inspirational quote thing, they get the half naked photo of you and an inspirational quote below. It's like, reality is wrong, dreams are for real. What? Fuck you!